Welcome to the tutorial for Adobe Illustrator to create the Dick Nelson Matrix. What is the matrix? The matrix is a series of arrays with four corners where they blend in equal steps to create a harmonious color palette. And this was created by Dick Nelson, who studied with Josef Albers in the 50s, who's the preeminent color theorist, one of them, of the 20th century. And the power of the matrix is essentially that you can create every single lesson that Josef Albers taught in his courses with the matrix. And for example, this is a matrix. On the left corner here, we have this cyan color, we have a blue here, we have a red here, we have an orange here, and there are equal steps. And in them, you're going to see things like halations. If you need to know more about that, look at some of the other videos previously. This video is intended to be sort of an advanced level in terms of, I'm not going to stop and pause and talk about the different selection tools like I did in the previous videos. What I'm going to do is show you the power of this stuff. So over here, we have two background colors, two swatches. The background's red and cyan. In the middle, we have two smaller swatches. And these colors, look at them, they look quite different. And in fact, they are, as we move in closer, the same. For more info on that, see same or different.com. If you move them apart, again, you're going to see, based on their relative background, they look quite different. Now, let me show you an example. So the background red here, I'm going to change this to background purple, okay? And I'm going to change this to the background orange. Now, the swatches are equal to the center of the matrix, meaning the center swatch is an equal blend of every four color. So, for example, let's say I want to make these two colors look the same. This is a second of Josef Albers' lessons or challenges, was to make two colors look the same even though they're different. I'm going to take a color closer to this purple-blue, like, let's say, here. And I'm going to, for the swatch within the orange context, take a color closer to that background. And you can see they sort of look similar. And of course, next to each other, they're going to appear quite different. We also get these added effects with halations that they sort of begin to appear like transparencies, films, veils. And this is all stuff that's in the Albers course that's been evolved by Dick Nelson. And so in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make a matrix. Hopefully you've watched the array video, which is critical. It gives you all the details. Before I go there, let me just show you one more example. Let me make this background cyan. And we already have this background orange. So this left background is the upper left corner of the matrix. This background is the bottom left corner of the matrix. And I need to change the swatches. And let's do this. Let's try to make these same colors appear as opposing colors backgrounds. So I'm going to make this look like this background, and this look like this background. Okay, so what I do is I click in this swatch here, and let me pick a color. Let's do this color here, and let's pick this color here. And if you watch closely, I actually picked the exact same color. So these two swatches are equal in color, but they appear different because color is relative. So every lesson, Dick Nelson discovered every lesson you could possibly create in from the Albers course could be done with the matrix. It's also phenomenal how many halations you get and just the beautiful effect you get. This is what I did with my website, Color is Relative, where I took the matrix and I made it interactive. And so you touch a color, the background changes, and you just get these luminous objects because every color is aware of each other. And the longer you look, the better it gets because your eye is fatiguing. And I've made a lot of art based on this stuff. You can see these are all single swatches of color. This is visionthroughcolor.com, a show I had in Amsterdam. And just using these basic concepts, creating really luminous artwork that's all harmonious, all aware of each other. Without further ado, how to create the matrix. Okay, so back to Illustrator. Let me go ahead and zoom back out. In the array tutorial, I showed you how to make, to show the grid, how to snap to the grid, all that stuff. And so what I'm going to do is make a square here. Let's go ahead and pick a color. Let's make this sort of a, let's just go with, doesn't matter, any color. I'm going to make this, let's make it pure blue. And I hit Command C, Command F to paste in front. I move this over to the right. I'm going to leave 5 steps in between. You can use 3, you can use 5. It's easier with odd numbers so you get a center to it, but you can use 12, 13, doesn't matter. I'll make this halfway to cyan, so it's just a very subtle change. And I'm going to copy paste in front, and I'm going to make this one very green and put a little blue in there, so it's sort of a olivey green, paste in front, and put this one as a peach. Okay, now make sure you have your settings set up. You go to Object from the menu, Blend Options, and make sure it says Specified Steps, and I have it set as 5 because I have 5 steps between each swatch. This is all basically similar to making an array. But what I'm going to do now is select the top 2 squares. I'm going to hold Option Command, hit B for blend, and you can see immediately, like, this is not a good blend. It's for whatever reason, it's just you don't see the steps here. So I want to adjust this, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this selection tool, click in here and change this, and see if I can find a color that gets better steps. See, that's already better. What I'm looking for is distinct steps of color. I don't even really like this so much because this looks like a really smooth blend, and this looks like a really dramatic blend. And sometimes that's just Illustrator. And so I want to add a little bit of red to this to get that. I mean, you just watch. I'm just going to tweak this stuff a little bit and find a blend that I really like. That's good. That's really doing a lot of value shifts right there. This is darker than this is, and so we get a lot of value there. But I'm seeing a lot of halations, meaning I'm seeing a lot of distinct, clear separations that I'm getting in this square here. A little bit of this color on this edge, a little bit of this color on this edge. So it's a really beautiful. That's a great array. Beautiful array. Let's keep that. And let's go down here. Let's do the Option Command B to blend. And that's not bad either. I don't know if I love the blend here. I might watch this. Here's a trick. I'll select that swatch. I will hit I for inspector. I'll change that to that one, and we'll see how that array is. That's better. Very subtle, but really nice steps. Okay, now if I was to select all these and hit blend, I get this funky Z thing. So don't do that. You've got to break them up. So you have both arrays selected. This is how to make the matrix. This is the key. Watch closely. Both arrays selected, go to Object, Blend, Expand. Okay? You see it broke out there, and now don't touch anything except the keyboard where you do Option Command Blend, and there we have our matrix. It's a very subtle matrix. It seems sort of autumn-y to me. But I'll show you how we can use this. So I take a background. And let's say I make this the upper left corner, and let's copy and paste that. I make that the, let's go to the bottom right corner. Now the swatches, if I make these swatches the middle color of the entire matrix, I'll just copy and paste that. Oh, and I changed the background, so let me go back. So these two swatches are the middle swatch of the matrix. And the background is meant to be the upper left corner and the bottom right corner. And you can see these two swatches look phenomenally different. And if I move them closer together, they're the same. Okay? So let's do this. That's just a great effect. Let's make this swatch closer to the upper left corner. And let's make this swatch closer to the lower right corner. And they appear quite different. But if I put them back on their backgrounds, they sort of look similar. So that's sort of like the parlor tricks of the matrix. But again, these are all techniques to create really luminous effects where every single color in this matrix is aware of every other color. And what that means is our eyes love it. We get halations, we get luminous transparencies, we get luminosity, and that's how you do it. That's the matrix, invented by Dick Nelson, furthering Josef Albers' color work. And if you have any questions, I look forward to hearing from you. Thanks very much.